I told y'all to send me videos that you thought I would like, and you did not disappoint. I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need. And I don't care about the presents. Underneath the Christmas tree, I don't need... His face at the very end with the bow.
I knew that.
Keep them coming. Today, I gotta tell you why Charli and Dixie D'Amelio's latest video is causing so much backlash that they've lost 1 million followers. Would you eat a human steak? The Holocaust Museum honors George Floyd, and a meme about what makes a complete woman has conservatives divided. I'm Alex Clark, and this is POPlitics. If you don't know already, the D'Amelio family is the most famous family on the internet right now. Their daughters, Charli and Dixie, got famous on TikTok, and it's all just blown up from there. This is Charli. No stalling, I'ma pull it off. God put you in my life for a purpose, and we might fuss and fight, but it's worth it. And this is her sister, Dixie. Their entire family has a YouTube channel now, and they decided to start a new series where the whole family has a famous celebrity over for dinner, a chef cooks for them, and then they tape it vlog style. Well, they just did their first one ever, and honestly, it may end up being their last because it's gone totally viral, but not in the way these girls are used to. It's viral because people are saying Charli and Dixie acted like total brats, and that the only mature one ended up being the celebrity guest, James Charles, a famous makeup YouTuber. Let's examine the evidence. Exhibit A. Charli mocks her dad when he tells everyone that he was the class clown in high school.
Senior superlative.
Class clown.
You're so stupid for that.
Exhibit B. The girls don't even act like they're listening when James Charles talks, and Dixie rudely interrupts his story to change the subject because she clearly just doesn't care about what he's telling them.
I was one of the coolest days of my entire life. And like even like it, like the photos turned out amazing, but like it just felt kind of like a normal photo shoot. It wasn't until I was in the group chat like with the editor in chief and stuff, and she sent over like a few different options like for the cover with the photo with the Vogue logo like edited on, and I was like, wow, like this is actually happening. Like this is so crazy.
That's so crazy.
So it's like things like that. Oh
no, we're not gonna do that. Isn't this food amazing?
It is. It's
very- Exhibit C. They have a private chef there making them dinner, and Dixie tries the food and legit barfs at the table.
And it brings you good luck and good fortune to eat it.
Try it.
It tastes like when a big wave hits you.
Do it.
And you...
Does it actually bring you good luck?
Good luck and good fortune, yes.
Liar.
Just do it.
Oh, Dixie, wait.
No, you're getting... It's...
Yummy.
See?
It sometimes happens when... Oh God.
So dramatic.
Don't be so dramatic. Yeah,
excuse yourself.
Is she being real? Or is she being dramatic? Oh, she actually threw off.
Exhibit D. Charli complains about not hitting 100 million followers on TikTok yet, and James ego checks her.
If we're thinking about it, okay, how far away is that's Friday? Okay. Ugh, I wish I had like more time. Because imagine if I hit 100 mil a year after hitting a mil.
Was the 95 not enough for you?
Okay, so those are the big pieces of evidence. Incriminating or not? I will say this, when I was in high school, I acted like them too. Full disclosure, so did all of my friends when I go to their house and have dinner with their families. And I'm a picky eater, but I would never barf at the table. I would barf in my pocket. The brattiness, for sure. It's just a teenager thing, I think, for the most part. But they are social media famous and basically filming a show. They know they're on camera, and they knew that they had a celebrity guest coming over. So why were they dressed like they didn't care at all and acting like they didn't care at all? It was cringy how rude they were being to James, honestly. And Charli has now lost over 1 million followers from this video.
People are dropping like flies.
The question is it fair to say they're children, so they acted like children, or was this really bad and they deserve the backlash? Let me know.
Such spoiled brats.
Singer Neyo said that the only way that he would perform at the Super Bowl is if the NFL agreed to certain terms regarding Black Lives Matter. He said the NBA dedicated their 2019 to 2020 season to Black Lives Matter, and he'd love to see the NFL do the same. Neyo said every team in the NBA had on Black Lives Matter. They made sure that you saw it. They made sure that it was a moment, and yet Colin Kaepernick can't still get a job. That makes no sense. Actually, it does make a lot of sense. He's not a very good football player.
Suck, 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 suck.
If the NFL makes a point to make everything about Black Lives Matter, he says that he'd be down to perform the Super Bowl. Except here's the thing, Neyo is a has-been artist. No one is asking him to do the Super Bowl halftime show, okay? He hasn't even had enough hits. I can't even remember the last time he's had a hit song. That's how long it's been.
It's time to let old things die.
I was singing about sexy love when I was 13 in seventh grade.
My sexy.
Not a fan of turkey for Thanksgiving? Don't worry, how about human steaks?
I have no plans to eat anybody.
There's a company that makes grow your own human steak. Don't worry though, they claim it's not technically cannibalism. It's called the Ouroboros steak, and the kit would come with everything you'll need to grow miniature human meat steaks using cells taken from the inside of your mouth.
I can taste it. On my tongue.
If you're drooling already, sorry to burst your bubble, but it's actually just an exhibit for a hypothetical product at the Philadelphia Museum of Art. So you can't actually try a bite of the human meat.
I was this close. This close!
I know the saying is, you are what you eat, but I think if this ever became real, that'd be a little too literal. Be honest, would you try this if one day it became a real product you could buy?
It's good.
Do me a favor, hit the like button and the save button really quick. Thank you. The Holocaust Center of Florida has decided to host an exhibit dedicated to George Floyd. I didn't know George Floyd was a Jew who was murdered in a German concentration camp. Oh, wait! He wasn't!
One of these things is not like the others.
I'm guessing that the museum is trying to imply that George Floyd's death is the result of some kind of ethnic genocide, except instead of one perpetrated by Hitler against Jews, it's white police officers against black men. Let's just set aside the fact that if that's the case, it is about as far from reality as it gets. And it's also unbelievably disrespectful to Holocaust victims.
Yeah, I'm pretty disgusted with the whole situation.
It is mind-blowing to me that a museum would go against the very people it was created to honor just to go woke.
Unbelievable.
I thought this was actually a Babylon Bee article when I first saw the headline. I asked some of our CUTEservatives in our JewServative subgroup what they thought, and here's what they had to say. Freda says, what happened to George Floyd and others killed by police is unfortunate, and maybe there are ways to handle these situations differently. However, it is in no way a Holocaust or even close to the scale of what was happening in Germany at the time. Jordan said, I think this is inappropriate and downplays the Holocaust. It should be its own thing, not added to the atrocity of 6 million Jews killed solely for being Jewish. And Katie says, it's tone deaf and downgrades the Jews' prosecution. This is all so typical of leftists to co-opt one group's oppression points for another group they deem more worthy. Just like the trans movement has taken over spaces that are solely for women, the Black Lives Matter movement is now taking over spaces that are meant for Jews.
I won't stand for it.
It's that day of the week where things start to get a little toasty.
Hot Take Tuesday.
Max Eric actually had the kahunas to say that Demi Lovato is using their breakup for clout.
Bye.
That's it. Max Eric is now the number one celebrity I despise the most. He says this after he goes back to the beach he proposed on and cries in front of the paparazzi, and then takes his new girlfriend to the same beach for pics to rub it in Demi's face. Sir, you're the freak of the week, and it isn't even Friday yet. He might have just taken the top spot, even beating out Jamila Jamil. Guys, that says a lot. Ooh, and Meghan Markle Green Bean.
I'm about to beat this bitch up.
Taylor Swift dropped two massive hints that she's cooking up something big. First of all, over the weekend, she popped off with this pic and captioned it, not a lot going on at the moment. The last time she posted a pic with that caption, she was recording Folklore. No big.
Something is coming. Something is gonna happen here. Soon.
Then, she went on the AMAs just to say that she's re-recording her old music. But she did it in front of a horoscope sign, aka twin fire signs, aka a lyric from a Red album.
Reason I'm not there tonight is I'm actually re-recording all of my old music in the studio where we originally recorded it. So it's been amazing and I can't wait for you to hear it. But have a great night. I love you so much. And thank you, please.
Swifties, we're getting the Red album revamped. This is it. It's our one chance to get the 10-minute version of All Too Well, I'm telling you. There's a meme about women empowerment that's gone viral, and what's interesting is it's caused a big polarization amongst conservatives. The Instagram account @womenontop posted a meme depicting two different types of women, the ones who want marriage and family and ones who want a dog or to travel and eat pizza, and then said they're both just as established and complete. The two arguments are this. Some conservatives are saying that there is nothing wrong with this and the meme is correct. It's totally a to each their own situation because not every woman has to get married or wants to get married and have children to feel complete. The other side argues that a meme like this is actually just trying to normalize selfishness in the name of feminism, and that at 31, maybe you'll be happy that you aren't married with kids, but the majority of women will end up being miserable and full of regret if they choose to never have a family by the time they're in their 50s. And so this sets a dangerous precedent. So let's hear it, CUTEservatives. What side are you on? I honestly see both sides.
What do women want?
We'll have one more special Thanksgiving-themed episode tomorrow that you can watch or listen to as you travel. Remember, we are available on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, all of the podcast apps. So subscribe, leave a 5-star review, and convert your family into CUTEservatives over the holiday break. Don't forget to like this episode if you haven't yet. Tell me what you think about the D'Amelios and what makes a complete woman. Share this episode to your story and with two friends who will desperately need a distraction after they spent a few days with their liberal cousins this Thanksgiving, okay? We all know them. It's pop culture without the propaganda every single day. I'm Alex Clark, and this is POPlitics. Click below to watch yesterday's episode. Please subscribe, thumbs up, share this video, and ring the bell for notifications so you never miss the conservative. And make sure you're following this show @POPlitics on Instagram for even more CUTEservative content.